What's up, YouTube? Look, I want to talk to you about 10 sad but true things that are preventing you from making gains. Now, there is so many different things I could have put here. There's freaking hundreds of things. I'm not just doing this so I can blab. I'm doing this so I can help you guys, so I can truly motivate some people and show people what they could be doing wrong and what they could be doing better. Let's look at the first thing, lack of cardio. Now, look, man, all y'all people making memes and all these stupid things on Facebook and Instagram talking about, oh, cardio, I can't do cardio, I'm losing my gains. Cardio equals loss of muscle. I worked out with some dudes that were bigger than me, stronger than me, but they sucked in the gym. Yes, they went heavy. They went heavier than me, but they had to rest 2 to 5 minutes in between sets. We're talking like chest presses. We're talking like pull downs and crap like that. Dude, you are not going to gain anywhere near as much muscle if you have to rest that long in between sets. 45 seconds to a minute rest is all you need and is definitely a good time of rest in between sets to build muscle. You're so winded, you can't do drop sets. You can't do negatives. You can't do your workout anywhere near as hard as you could because you have no stamina. You've been listening to everybody tell you that you're gonna burn muscle up by doing cardio. Stupid, stupid, stupid. Listen, don't go overboard with the cardio, but use cardio to your advantage. You will have killer, high-paced, fast-paced workouts that are gonna help you train at a more intense level if you have the endurance that cardio gives you. Number two, you don't count your macros. Dude, listen, you're eating chili, you're like, oh, one scoop, that's gotta have 20 grams of protein in it. Two scoops, oh, that's gotta have 40 total. Here's the thing what I find with people. They don't count their macros, and when they finally do count their macros, they are so under eating, it's ridiculous. When they thought they were eating 300 grams of protein, they're eating 100 grams of protein. When they think they're eating 500 grams of carbs, they're eating 200 grams of carbs, and it's all sugary bullcrap. And they're eating way more fat than they should. Be smart about your training and count your macros. Yes, it can be a pain in the butt sometimes, but it is worth the effort. You must get enough protein. You must have enough carbohydrates to facilitate hardcore workouts, unless you're training like a pansy, and you must have enough fat that is gonna do a lot of different things for you. Count the macros, man. Number three, you have a lack of motivation. You're not motivated. You're going to the gym and it's the same dang thing. You're walking in the door and out the door and you're working out and you're exercising, but you're not accomplishing much. Listen to me, man. You think you're doing okay. You're doing your everyday routine and you think you're okay. Oh man, dude, I'm motivated. I'm fired up. No, you're not. You're not where you could be right now. You're not where you should be and you know it. You know you need to put a fire under your butt. You're not doing anything hardcore in the gym. You're dead. Dude, look, go get you a good workout video. Go get Blood and Guts by Dorian Yates. Go watch Ronnie Coleman's videos. Pick up some bodybuilding magazines. Get back to that place, dude, where you are going above and beyond in your workouts. Dude, you should never be mediocre in the gym. You should be so fired up, so motivated that you are just having the best workout ever every single day on the daily. Number four, you care too much about what people think about you in the gym. Dude, stop, don't look at me like that. I know, dude, you know what I'm talking about. You're too busy trying to look cool in the dang gym. You're too worried about your outfit in the gym. You're too worried about looking like GQ and trying to look like you got all the high-tech athletic apparel. Bullcrap, you're too worried about it, and because of that, it's hindering you. Why? Because visually in the gym, you don't want people to see you getting all types of dirty. And here's another thing, here's the big thing with it. You're afraid to go crazy in the gym. That's straight up sad but true. You are too concerned, you're too nervous, you're too worried about chicks seeing you work out like an animal. You're too worried about the gym staff thinking things about you, like you're afraid to get in trouble by them. I don't know what it is. Go in that gym, dude. Listen to me. Don't care what they think about you, dude. Go in that gym and freaking kill it, dude. Moving on, number five. You're too distracted. You're too distracted in the gym. How many times do you go in the gym? I will tell you myself. How many times do I go in the gym and I see everybody freaking fickling with their dang telephone? They're freaking answering text messages on the phone. They're fickling with their dang playlist. Oh, I don't like this song. I'm doing squats, so I gotta put this song on. Oh, there's a commercial on Pandora, so I gotta skip this. Fickling with that stupid freaking telephone. You will not find me with headphones or telephone because I don't want to mess with the electronics, bruh. Listen, I deal with enough electronics at work, bro, and every other time of day. I don't want to mess with electronics. I want to mess with steel, bruh. Mindless cold steel, okay? Other distractions, talking to chicks. Listen, I like talking to chicks. I feel you, bruh. I feel you, dude. But listen, the gym ain't the time to sit there and stop in the middle of your set and be talking to some chick for half an hour. You're talking with your homeboys. Listen, make up your mind that when you go to the gym, the little time that you have in there, hour to 2 hours, make that your time.